Yes, 11th class. Is the Python window visible? So I am starting with the very basic concepts. Okay. Then I'll be revising each and every topic with you. Right. So let us start with the arithmetic operators. Like I have 10 plus 3. Plus is for addition. 10 minus 3. Subtraction. 10 multiply 3 multiply, 10 divide by 3, okay, 10 floor division 3, 10 modulus 3, 1. Yes, Gurjot, it is the very old version, that is why this problem is coming. I know what question you want to ask. That 10 divide by 3 should be in decimals. Yes, it should be in decimals. When we use the, this is the old version, beta. Okay. In the new version, when you use this divide operator, like I type here in the notepad, or I type in the next version, I say 10 divide by 3. This is the new version. See. Am I clear? So the difference between both the operators is when you use single forward, single slash, it always displays the number in fractional form. But when you take the floor division, it eliminates the fractional part. It will eliminate the fractional part. Am I clear with all the arithmetic operators? Now I continue with the relational operators. I have A equal to 10. I have B equal to 20. I have C equal to 30. Okay. Now A more than B. Relational operators are the operators that are used for comparisons, and the result of such operations is either true, either false. The result is either true, either false. Am I clear? Am I clear to all? So A more than B, 10 more than 20, is it false? Better remember one thing. True and false. They are Boolean variables. True means one, false means zero. But they are keywords also. Ye keywords bhi hain. And T is capital, F is capital. Now they are not keywords. Now they are not keywords. Okay. But when T is capital, it is a keyword also. And when the result will be displayed, carefully notice, when the result is displayed, F is capital, T is capital. Same you are to write in your answer sheet also. While displaying the results of the relational expressions, or the logical expressions, your T of true and F of false must be in capitals. Now, A equal equal to C. Is A equal to C? False. A less than C? True. B not equal to C? True. Okay? Clear? Now I go with the logical operators. There are basically three logical operators: or, and, not. They are also keywords. They are also keywords. They are operators as well as keywords. A less than equal to b or a more than c. Logical OR operator says you take two expressions, two operands. If either of operand is true, the result is true. दो ऑपरेंड लीजिए, अगर दो ऑपरेंड दोनों ट्रू है तो रिजल्ट ट्रू है, अगर एक भी ऑपरेंड फॉल्स हो गया, एक ऑपरेंड ट्रू है रिजल्ट ट्रू है, अगर दोनों फॉल्स हैं तो रिजल्ट फॉल्स है. इफ बोथ आर ट्रू, ट्रू. इफ एनी वन इज ट्रू, अगेन ट्रू. बट result will be false only and only if both the expressions are false. Am I clear? So here you see a less than equal to b, 10 less than equal to 20, true. A more than c, ab ye false hai, one is true, one is false, so result will be true. Okay, now say B equal to C and C more than A. Now logical AND says result will be true only and only if both the expressions are true. Result will be true only and only if both the expressions are true. If any of the expression is false, the result will be false. Now, as per this question, B is not equal to C. 20, 30 ke barabar nahi hai. So, ye to false ho gaya. Ab AND operator mein, agar ek operand false ho gaya, the result will be false. Am I clear to everyone? I say A not equal to C or not C more than B. Now, as per this expression, the NOT operator is a unary operator. NOT operator require one operand and it reverses the operation. It acts like the inverter. If expression result is true, it will make it false. And if the result of expression is false, it will make true. Ye true ko false kar dega, false ko true kar dega. Am I clear? So, A not equal to C, 10 is not equal to 30, true, or not, C more than B, C 30 more than 20, ये true था, ये true था, लेकिन बाहर लगा हुआ है not, so what not did, not make it false, C more than B was true, but NOT operator make it false. So first expression is true, second is false, result is true. Okay, am I clear to all? Now, X is equal to 20, Y equal to 20. Now I have X is Y. Beta is and is not, you remember? Is operator will give the value true if both the operands are pointing to the same value. If both the operands, both the variables are having the same value, then the result of is operator will be true. Okay? Am I clear? Now, if I say Z equal to 40, right? And I say X is Z, it is false because X and Z, they are not pointing to the same value. They are not pointing to the same value. Am I clear to everyone? Yes. Am I clear? Now I type one program in front of you. Just to make one practice of the question. I am taking A equal to 30, B equal to 40, C equal to 50, right? Or you can input them as per your convenience. I have initialized them. You can input them if you want. Total equal to A plus B plus C. Print total now. If you want to find the average, then you can find total divide by 3. Okay, and you can print the average also. Clear? A very simple program to find the total and average of three numbers. To find the total and average of three numbers. Right? Now, if you want to input the numbers, what you can do here? A equal to integer function input. Enter the first number. Now, why I have taken the integer function? Who will tell me? Why I have taken the integer function? Why not I directly work with the input function? Why there was need to take the input function? Sorry, integer function. Yes, who will tell? Riddhi. Yes, Riddhi, unmute yourself.
Sir, integer function removes decimal.
Integer remove decimal.
Sir, मतलब decimal वाले जो part है वो नहीं display होगा answer display होगा.
But okay, this can be the reason, but what is the main reason for taking the integer function? Can I do this? My question is, can I directly take input function? Input function input करवा रहा है मेरा number तो मुझे integer yes, I think Pragati has raised hand. Yes, Pragati, unmute yourself where you are. Yes, Pragati, unmute yourself and tell me.
Yes, sir, because when we take the value from the user, yes. Which means that we are inputting any value, it is first of all a string. Because of yes. Which it we cannot yes. Perform operations on a string. Therefore, we need to convert the string into an integer.
Right. Very right. Beta, whenever we are inputting anything from input function, the data is always in the form of string. Whether you input any name, whether you input any number, it is in the form of string. And you cannot perform mathematical calculations on the string. So that is why if you want to input proper numeric form number, you have to take integer. And if you want to have floating type number, then you have to take float function. Then you have to take float function. Am I clear? Why we take int and float function? I again repeat, when we input the data via input function, the data is always in the form of string. So if you want to work with the numeric data, you have to use integer or float function. Clear? Am I clear up till here? Then next program we make let us have one more revision of the program. Yes, we can solve one mathematical function like power square root. You input the number x equal to input int input, enter the number. Okay. Suppose you want to find the square root of a number, y equal to math dot square root function x. But if you are taking this inbuilt function square root, you have to import the math library. Import is also keyword. अगर आप कोई भी inbuilt function use करना चाहते हो तो उसकी corresponding library you have to import. Right? Now square root function is the inbuilt function of math module. That is why I have taken this module initially. That is why I have import this module initially. Similarly, you can find the power of the number z equal to math dot power x comma 3. Am I clear? You can find the power x comma 3. Am I clear? Yes, 11th class, am I clear up till here? Okay, I open the first quiz in front of you. Okay, whosoever knows the answer, just raise your hand, okay? I will unmute you one by one. Who developed Python? Guido van Rossum, Charles Babbage, Thomas E. Kurtz, Williams. Yes, Dia, unmute yourself.
Gordon van Rossum.
Guido van Rossum, okay. Second question, what are the merits of Python? Yes, Devanshi, unmute yourself.
Sir, all above.
All above. Next question, what is another name of interactive mode? What is another name of interactive mode? Yes, Himanshu, unmute yourself.
Sir, script mode.
No, script mode is a separate mode. There are two type of mode. Interactive mode and script mode. I am asking the other name of interactive mode. Yes, Samriddhi, unmute yourself.
Sir, Python shell.
Python shell. Okay. Which of the following is the demerit of Python? Which of the following is the demerit of Python? speed limitation, work in mobile compute, weak in mobile computing, runtime errors, all about. Yes, Diya, unmute yourself.
Sir, all about.
All about. Okay. Which of the following language is an open source language? Yes. Which among the following is an open source language? Yes, Yuvraj, unmute yourself.
Sir, Python.
Python. IDLE stands for Integrated Development Environment, Internet Design Evolution, Integrated Design Environment, Integrated Decoding Enhancement. Yes, Riddhi, unmute yourself.
Sir, first option.
First option, Integrated Development Environment. All right. It is the mode in which output is sandwiched between the commands. Yes, Kavya.
Interactive mode.
Interactive mode. Which function key is used to execute the Python program? Yes, Devanshi. Yes, Devanshi. Unmute yourself. Which function key is used to execute the Python program? Devanshi, am I audible? Yes, Devnoor, you answer the question. Unmute yourself.
The F5.
F5, very good. It is a or R type of token. Only 3-4 students are raising the hand. What about others? Harnoor Kaur, unmute yourself and answer the question. Yes, Harnoor Kaur.
Identifiers.
Unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
It is or are type of token.
Identifiers.
Pick up the correct option from the following.
Sir, it is identifiers.
Identifiers. Ramanjeet, unmute yourself.
Backspace.
Ramanjeet, unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
Escape sequence backslash B stands for?
Backspace.
Backspace. B option.
We can submit the result. Okay. Okay. Now moving to the next quiz. Ashutosh, are you here in the lecture? Arshdeep, Yashika, is the quiz visible to everyone? All right. A comma B equal to 10 comma 5, X comma Y equal to A plus B comma B minus 2. Print X and Y. What will be the value of X and Y? Ashutosh, unmute yourself and answer the question. Yes, Ashutosh. Yes, Riddhi.
Sir, what?
First option. First option, 15,3. Yes, it is correct. 10 plus 5, 15, it get assigned to X. Then 5 minus 2, 3 assigned to Y, 15, 3. Very right, very correct. Now comes the second question. A comma B 10 comma 15, X 20, Y 25, A equal to X plus Y minus B, X equal to A plus B minus Y plus 10. Yes. Who will answer this question? Devanshi, you answer it.
Sir, C option.
What is first value A? X plus Y minus B. X is 20, Y 25. 45, 45 minus 15. 45 minus 15.
Sir, 30.
30. So B option is correct. 30 comma 30. Okay. Third MCQ. What is the size of this string? Triple quoted string. What is the size of the string? Is it 28, 30, 26 or 20? Yes, Riddhi, answer it.
Sir, 26.
Why 26? Triple quoted string also counts the end of line. E, welcome ke E ke baad, enter key press hui, end of line. That is also to be counted. It is 28. Okay. Am I clear?